how you two tragically lost your minds at the sight of her mangled body.
So he's willing to drive them crazy or basically erase their brains to preserve this little legacy he's created for himself.
Come here, Harry. Together you and I make the front page.
Wow, you really are good at that.
I know, I told you. The only thing I was missing was a little wink.
Oh, boy.
Hi, and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist, and I am a Ravenclaw.
I am Alan Seawright. I am an unlicensed filmmaker, and I'm basic. I'm a Gryffindor.
I'm basic. You're basic.
You're basic.
What are we doing today, man? What do you got me primed for?
You know how you just love reacting to things?
Uh-huh.
I figured, what better to react to in the Harry Potter universe than just the character of Gilderoy Lockhart?
I love Gilderoy Lockhart.
Can you possibly imagine a better way to serve detention than by helping me to answer my fan mail?
And so I'm going to grace... Little preview, you stay with us. I'll give you some Lockhart impressions later on. You can be the judge if they're any good.
Stick around.
Celebrity is as celebrity does. Remember that.
Mr. Gilderoy Lockhart.
Mum fancies him.
Make way there, please. Let me by.
You know Kenneth Branagh just had a great time with this.
Girl, this is for the Daily Prophet.
Literally the most fun he's ever had.
It can't be Harry Potter.
Harry Potter! Excuse me, madam.
Nice big smile, Harry. Together you and I rate the front page. Ladies and gentlemen, what an extraordinary moment this is.
Switches his voice.
When young Harry stepped into Flourish and Blotts this morning to purchase my autobiography, Magical Me.
And the faint humility.
Oh, the smarm.
Incidentally,
it's
so good. Celebrating its 27th week atop the Daily Prophet bestseller list. He had no idea that he would in fact be leaving with my entire collected works free of charge.
Free of charge.
Now, ladies.
Harry, now you give me those.
Oh, my goodness.
All of you wait outside. That's it,
John. So, textbook narcissist or novel narcissist?
When you say that, you're asking, is this what a narcissist actually looks like, or is this just for the sake of the film?
Yeah.
I mean, he's definitely hamming it up. There's an element of overdoing it here for comedic sake. But yeah, the self-obsession coupled with the assumption that you'd be happy to get anything from me or be associated with me in any way, as well as using other people as a means to elevate himself.
Right, as a prop.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, exactly, as a prop. I mean, that is real narcissism. And it's usually, sometimes it's, I mean, Lockhart, at least until the end, he's fairly harmless.
Right.
He's just a buffoon.
Spooky how the time flies when one's having fun.
Sometimes narcissism is quite a bit more insidious.
Let me introduce you to your new defense against the dark arts teacher. Me.
Yeah.
Gilderoy Lockhart. Order of Merlin, third class. Honorary member of the Dark Force Defense League and 5 times winner of Witch Weekly's...
Oh, man. The self-portrait of painting a self-portrait.
But I don't talk about that.
Might be my favorite thing ever.
By smiling at them.
Also, I'm sure this has been brought up in the Harry Potter fandom by people smarter than me, but...
Be warned. It is my
Dumbledore is, you know, this amazing wizard who's the best headmaster that Hogwarts has ever had, right?
Right.
He is terrible at hiring. You may find yourself legitimately awful at it.
Yeah. Room. I don't know if he even has any sort of strategy.
Can befall you whilst I am.
It seems to just be random.
I must ask you not to scream.
Actually, I'm trying to, because I know why he hired Lupin. Like, there are several people that you get it.
Well, I'm not even talking Defense Against the Dark Arts. Like, you know, he hires Trelawney, who is terrible. He hires Snape, who is an abusive jerk.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't really have an explanation for why Dumbledore does the things he does. You guys in the comments, Potterheads, you could let us know. Oh, poor Longbottom. I mean, he grows up to be a hunk, so it's okay.
Pesky pixie pester nobby!
Look at his foppish hair. Everything about him is foppish. He's a foppish dandy.
Really, my goal was to get you to say foppish dandy. So, mission accomplished.
So here's something, because we talked about, we did an episode on the Invisible Man, right?
Yeah.
And we talked about, I mean, the villain in that film is a narcissist as well. And one of the defining characteristics of a narcissist is that they believe themselves to have extraordinary capabilities, or that they are, for some reason, a cut above everybody else.
Right.
Right? Sometimes it's based on reality. They can do one or two things really well, and they extrapolate that to
everything.
Yeah. In other cases, they really are complete idiots.
Tut, tut. Hardly any of you remember that my favorite color is lilac.
Who are non-contributing zeros when it comes to the world. And I think in Lockhart's case, I mean, we see he knows that he's a fraud. But he's obsessed with how people perceive him. Mm-hmm. And that's where his worth comes from. What do you think is the difference between arrogance and confidence?
Well, one of them's backed up, right? My confidence is rooted in the knowledge that in a given situation, I will handle myself well and will contribute. Mm-hmm. And arrogance is the assumption that in a given situation, I will handle myself and or contribute with no basis in evidence or fact or previous experience.
So unlucky I wasn't there. I know exactly the countercurse that could have spared her.
Yeah, it's an unproven assumption.
Yeah.
Or if there was previous experience, it may have been you got lucky one time, but you figure you got it going on. No, I hadn't thought of it that way, but that is, I think that's valid. The way I think of it is, arrogance is others need to be down so I can be up.
Oh, yeah, that's...
Like, if I'm arrogant, then I assume that I'm superior.
Right.
And that others are beneath me. If I'm confident, I just know, I know who I am. And I'm all about lifting others up and helping
them. I don't need to be better than anyone else. Yeah. I can just be good.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And if you look at actually the best characters in Harry Potter, the ones who really matter to him, the ones who really make an influence on him, especially you look at Dumbledore, Dumbledore doesn't have any arrogance in him.
No.
But he projects immense confidence.
It was foolish of you to come here tonight, Tom.
Lockhart doesn't respect anybody.
No.
You know, and I think that's what real arrogance is. What a putz.
What are you talking about, Harry? I think we're getting a bit drowsy.
but what a delightful putz as played.
So much fun.
By Kenneth Branagh, and is written in the book. I just can't get enough. He's awful, honestly, but I can't get enough of him.
Sort of my test of casting in a film is if I've read the book and then see the film and then read the book again, do I picture the character as cast in the films?
Yeah.
And I still don't read Gilderoy Lockhart as played by Kenneth Branagh.
Oh.
He's just different in my head when I read the book.
Okay.
Fame is a fickle friend, Harry.
This Lockhart is just as good.
Yeah.
It's just not, it's not mine, but it's still, man, it's great.
What do we do now?
Immobilus!
Okay, so this is just the end of the scene.
Okay, can we make a comment on something really quick here about Hermione? Something someone commented somewhere that I think is beautiful. You know, we'll step aside from J.K. Rowling as a public person right now. We're gonna back away from that.
There are issues.
But J.K. Rowling as an author did something so cool, which is she wrote a novel series with a male protagonist so little boys would read it.
Mm-hmm.
And the best character, the true hero, is the little girl.
Yeah. Yeah. It's the sneakiest bit of feminist subterfuge in human history.
You really are the brightest witch of your age.
Thank you.
Are you okay?
No. I think my arm's broken.
Not to worry, Harry. I will fix that arm of yours straight away.
No. Not you.
Oh, poor boy. He doesn't know what he's saying. Now, this won't...
Unfounded confidence in their abilities. Yeah, that's narcissism.
Brachium.
Emendo!
This is a fun bit of practical. Ugh.
Ah, yes. Well, that can sometimes happen. the point is, you can no longer feel any pain. And very clearly, the bones are not broken.
Broken? There's no bones left!
Much more flexible, though.
Much more flexible, though.
Gather! Always got a reason, always got something to cover himself.
Can you all
hear me? Excellent.
Excellent. In light of the dark events of recent weeks, Professor Dumbledore has granted me permission to start this little dueling club to train you all up in case you ever need to defend yourselves, as I myself have done on countless occasions.
For more information, see my published works.
I am disturbed at how well Jono knows Gilderoy Lockhart's lines.
Let me introduce my assistant, Professor Snape. He has sportingly agreed to help me with a short demonstration. Now, I don't want any of you youngsters to worry. You'll still have your potions master when I'm through with him.
Never fear.
Never fear.
With a little wink. They both have extraordinarily awful hair as part of their characters, and I wouldn't change a thing.
True. Very true.
One.
Also, how much fun did the two of these actors have?
Three.
Expelliarmus!
Do you think he's all right?
Who cares?
An excellent idea to show them that, Professor Snape, but if you don't mind me saying, it was
pretty obvious
what you're about to do. And if I had wanted to stop you, it would have been only too easy.
Perhaps it would be prudent to first teach the students to block unfriendly spells, Professor.
An excellent suggestion, Professor Snape. Let's have a volunteer pair. Potter, Weasley, how about you?
Weasley's wand causes devastation with the simplest spells. We'll be sending Potter to the hospital wing.
I'm just noticing Rupert Grint's pretty good in this movie.
Rupert Grint is the unsung hero of the entire series, honestly. Like, you know, I mean, all of the actors, especially into the later films,
yeah,
you know, grow into acting really well.
Yeah.
But he is asked to do the biggest, broadest stuff.
Yeah.
Which, you know, is really fun, but it's also really hard to do and not make stupid.
Yeah, yeah.
And he really nails it.
He'll know what to do.
Starting with this one, he's still, you know, he's like 12 or 13.
Yeah.
Doing this, and they're asking him to do some really silly things.
That's horrible.
And he makes it totally believable and fun.
And a lot, and so much of it is reacting, but his utter just disgust at Lockhart.
Yeah.
Do you think he's all right?
Who cares?
Really tells us as an audience, yeah, this guy's...
Well, Lockhart's a cartoon character, but...
He is who I would expect to be underneath the monster mask in a Scooby-Doo cartoon.
Professor High White!
Oh, yeah, 100%. But yeah, it's the kids' reactions to him that make it a believable movie instead of we're watching a live-action cartoon.
Uh-huh.
And the kids do a really good job, but especially Rupert Grint. Yeah, you're right.
So sorry, dozed off. What have I missed?
A girl has been snatched by the monster, Lockhart. Your moment has come at last.
My moment?
Weren't you saying just last night that you've known all along where the entrance to the Chamber of Secrets is?
That's settled. We'll leave you to deal with the monster, Gilderoy. Your skills, after all, are legend.
Very well. I'll just be in my office getting ready.
I'm not lying.
There was nothing in the job description about
it. You're running away? After all that stuff you did in your books?
Books can be misleading.
You wrote them.
My dear boy, do use your common sense. My books wouldn't have sold half as well if people didn't think I'd done all those things.
You're a fraud.
Oh, don't look
You've
so
just
shocked.
Been taking credit for what other wizards have done.
Is there anything you can do?
Yes, now you mention it. I'm rather gifted with memory charms.
Otherwise, you see.
See, he's not a complete zero. He's rather gifted with memory charms.
No, he's like Michael Scott without scruples, who's good at one thing, which is sales, and they made him manager for some reason, and he's an idiot.
Don't even think about it.
Oh my gosh, he is the Michael Scott of Harry Potter.
He's Michael Scott before Michael Scott, like, develops a heart, you know, as the Office goes on.
Yeah, he's first three seasons Michael Scott.
He's first three seasons Mike. No, he really is. Like,
A lot of people think that magic camp is just for kids, and that's why so many other people in my class were kids. Self-fulfilling prophecy.
Oh boy.
What's this?
Wanting everyone's acceptance.
Looks like a...
barbecuing his foot on snake. Accident.
It's a snake skin.
The only difference is it works for Lockhart, like people do adore him.
This must be 60 feet long.
The world will know our story, how I was too late to save the girl. How you two tragically lost your minds at the sight of her mangled body.
So he's willing to drive them crazy or basically erase their brains to preserve this little legacy he's created for himself.
Mm-hmm. To your memories.
Obliviate!
Game of Thrana is so delightful here.
Hello.
Who are you?
Ron Weasley.
Really? And who am I?
that little who am I is one of my favorite line deliveries ever in film.
No.
Really?
And who am I? It's just
like how he pauses.
So understated, but I mean, it's just, it's so good. It's so good.
So let's break this down, though, as far as like something that we can actually apply for our real lives.
Yes, please, because so far this has just been wacky fun.
Well, so if you're dealing with somebody who believes themselves to be extraordinary. And you see signs
against
that,
all evidence.
Against all evidence, right?
We all know those people.
And very often they will treat other people well as long as those people can serve them.
Sure.
Right? As long as those people can build them, like, come here, Harry. Together you and I make the front page.
Wow, you really are good at that.
I know, I told you. The only thing I was missing was a little wink.
Oh boy. I actually feel charmed.
I know, thank you.
I do feel charmed by that.
So he gets Harry and he's like, we're on the front page together. Like, it's all about how can you serve me? And here's why I'm so great and so wonderful. And even going to the point of making crap up.
Yeah.
Making crap up to make themselves look good. Like, now I don't need to tell anybody watching this you're dealing with a narcissist, but here's the takeaway, here's the rub, is they may seem harmless. Not all narcissists are abusive, controlling gaslighters. Some of them seem like harmless goofballs that are just full of themselves.
It was pretty obvious what you're about to do. And if I had wanted to stop you, it would have been only too easy. Mm-hmm.
Until their legacy is threatened.
Right.
Until this little image that they've created to put out into the world so that they can bask in everyone's adulation, until that's threatened. And then a real ugliness and a real nastiness comes out.
You first, Mr. Potter. Say goodbye to your memories.
Harmless animals can become aggressive when they're cornered.
Yeah.
When you're dealing with someone who seems like a benign narcissist, you have to ask yourself, they're so smug and such idiots that I really just want to take them down a peg. And, you know, maybe you can, maybe you should, but beware. Because a lot of times, people like that, there's a dark side underneath that they may not even know is there. But when their legacy is threatened, now you could be dealing with somebody who becomes dangerous.
Yeah.
Who becomes one of these narcissistic monsters, who becomes controlling, who becomes jealous, who becomes possessive, who becomes a gaslighter. And so, if someone seems like a harmless narcissist, let him be.
There's no such thing.
Let him, yeah.
A narcissist is a narcissist. They will somehow, in some way, cause problems at some point.
Yeah. So just let him down gently, back away, let him live in their delusions.
Yeah.
And that's where they will actually do the least amount of harm.
Yeah. I, especially when I was younger, had a bit of a savior complex. And so, you know, I would recognize, you know, I was fairly with it or whatever, but I recognized there were a couple of specific cases of narcissists in my life, and I recognized early on what they were, and I was like, I could help them. Mm. I could help them overcome this. Spoiler alert, I didn't. I got hurt, and they got off scot-free. I mean, they're still narcissists. They drive people away, and they have issues.
And that's why you want to help them, yeah. Right? Because a narcissist is ultimately pretty lonely, which is why they continually chase the acceptance of other people and then create a situation where they push those people away, right? And then they have to blame it on the other person because, no, it can't be me.
Right.
Right? And so, yeah, a lot of times you look at a person like that and you're like, I want to help.
Yeah, and I learned through painful trial and error that I can't do that.
Yeah.
You can do that if they seek help from you.
Yeah.
In a manner like this one.
I'm swaddling you.
I know what you do.
I'm swaddling you.
I know what you...
Also, if you want to rent or buy Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets or all the films, we have a link down there. We get a little affiliate kickback, which helps us to produce this show.
And as always, please like, subscribe, hit the bell, share with your friends. Hit the share button, text, tweet, Insta, whatever, face, gram, book. I suck at social media. I'm officially an old man now.
Wow, because that was long and rambly, just like an old man.
I'm telling you, I'm in a state of mental decline.
Thanks for listening.
So until next time, Obliviate.
Harry Potter must not go to Hogwarts this year. Oh, bad! Bad, Dobby, bad!
And
watch movies.
I'm so sorry. So sorry. Dobby is terrible. Jono as Dobby, also terrible.
You may find yourselves facing your worst fears in this room. Know only that no harm can befall you whilst I am here.